You're watching Mobile World Live. Now, sadly, MWC20 Barcelona, of course, didn't happen this week, but that didn't stop the mobile industry from having a very busy few days. We've had media launches taking place in Barcelona and around the world, and our own GSMA teams have become very innovative on ways to deliver some of the content that would have taken center stage at the event. In this short program, Mobile World Live is going to cover everything that's made the headlines in the last few days. Think of this as a bit of an alternative MWC wrap-up show. Joining me in our London studio, we've got Kavit Majithia from Mobile World Live. We also have Zara Chaudhry from the GSMA's Conference and GLOMO Awards team. And we have Peter Yarrick, head of GSMA Intelligence. Welcome all. Thank you very much for joining us.
Hey, Justin. Thanks for having us.
Thank you very much, folks. Kavit, I'll come to you first. Now, one of the big highlights of every MWC, of course, is the device launches. I believe you have actually attended one of the biggest ones this week, right?
I did. I mean, it was a bit different to a traditional device launch because there was no device there. It was a stream held by Huawei in London. It was a sort of virtual event where they showed their pre-recorded keynote presentation, which was recorded actually in Barcelona.
Should we have a look at that?
Yeah.
Here we go. Here's Huawei's big launch this week.
Today, we bring the new product, the upgrade version for this Mate X. It's a Mate XS. So you can see it's an amazing large screen, 8-inch immersive screen.
A new foldable there from Huawei. Kavit, what do you make of that?
Well, it's interesting. I mean, it's a year on from the first Mate X. Which didn't actually go according to plan because, you know, there was delays because of its durability and the questions about it being properly foldable and if it would break and stuff. And it also didn't launch outside of China. So this one, they're saying, is going to launch in numerous markets from next month. The price, I think, is a bit of an issue, 2,500 euros, which, well,
it's a lot of money.
Yeah, it's a lot of money. And it doesn't come with Google's apps and services relating to the ban, the US ban. So Huawei are pushing out their own app gallery and their own sort of mobile services ecosystem. And it'll be interesting to see if people are prepared to pay that amount of money for something that's not really tested.
Yep. Huawei's sub-brand, Honor, also got in on the action this week as well, didn't they? They had a stream Monday evening. Yep. Can you tell us a little bit about what they announced?
Yeah, they've announced the 9X Pro, which is the next phone from the 9X, which I think they launched last year. Bit of a different price point, 250 euros, so a bit cheaper, but again, no access to Google, so we'll see how that fares. It's also available globally, not just China. So, yeah.
Thank you, Kavit. Now, another major vendor also unveiled a device this week from Sony in Japan. Let's take a look at what they had to say.
This is the flagship Xperia 1 Mark II.
Peter, Sony.
Yes.
Struggled a bit recently, haven't they, in the smartphone space? But what do you make of this new device?
Yeah, I think it's interesting. Obviously, follow on to the first device, Mark II, you know, nice way to remind us of that. There's a couple of interesting things here, right? To your point, if I'm a vendor, I'm trying to differentiate myself. You see some of what they've done, right, in terms of looking at camera technology that they're pulling in from their DSLR line, right? So they can say there's some cool things there, differentiate themselves. What I think is particularly interesting is this is one of those flagships. There's no 4G-only variant. It's a 5G phone. Mm-hmm. You get it, you got 5G, you want it with just 4G, sorry, right? And I think why that's really interesting is it's something we've been talking about that operators are going to do, right? Operators are going to say, don't bring me a smartphone, don't bring me a flagship that doesn't have 5G. And you're beginning to see that with launches like this, which I think is, you know, it sort of ties into the larger push around 5G. It's kind of it's a nice message.
So we've had Sony, Huawei, Honor. But it wasn't just about devices this week, Peter. We also saw talk of networks and infrastructure and 5G use cases as well. And that was from Qualcomm, wasn't it? I think Tuesday night, Mobile World Live streamed their big press event. Anything that surprised you from that?
Yeah, out of the Qualcomm event, I would say probably not. I mean, I think what you're going to see out of those events, clearly it makes sense, and they've been talking about this for a while, their success on driving out what's going on the device side of things, what they're doing in terms of just promoting 5G, right? And providing that sort of roadmap of what comes next. And I think they've always done a really good job of that. Like, talking about technologies, trying to basically drive this vision of a rising tide carrying all boats, right? Let's get behind 5G. Two things I think were kind of interesting, though. One, right, their push around AR, VR, XR, mixed reality, whatever we want to call it, which they've been talking a lot about, right? But then taking this to the next step of working on reference designs, getting this out there. Obviously, there's a huge link to 5G, and you saw some of those discussions. But then beyond that, you don't always think of them as an infrastructure player, right? Qualcomm used to have more infrastructure chipsets. They kind of moved out of that space, but they moved back into it on sort of the small cell side with their FSM product line. And you see that coming up again, right? Which I think is interesting. They had a lot of people testimonials to their work with Qualcomm on the network side of things. And I think what's interesting there is it kind of points to the diversification, particularly for 5G, about it's not just macro coverage, but we're getting to the point where we're thinking about in-building coverage, big operator pain point, right? Big play into things like IoT, right? If we're trying to do IoT, we're trying to get coverage there, you're trying to meet some SLAs. In-building's important, operators see that. So I think you're seeing the pieces fit together, which was kind of a nice story.
So we've had some big press events. We've heard lots about 5G, foldable phones back on the agenda again, VR from Qualcomm. Some of the big topics I think that would have made headlines from the conference agenda at MWC 20 Barcelona. Let's bring in Zara now. Zara, you're a member of the team that spent months putting together the conference sessions that would have taken place at MWC Barcelona. But the good news is that all that effort didn't go to waste, right?
No, we innovated. So our labor of love had a chance to shine through here. So we had hundreds of speakers confirmed, as you know. And the main thing to remember here is the conversations on site at Barcelona matter. This is a really chance for the industry to come together, to solve problems together, and kind of come away with innovation. And we wanted to make sure that there was still, we still had a platform for that. So we reached out to a number of our speakers, and they were very excited to get on board. And we've launched a whole MWC short series, which is available on our website. And what we've done here is had a number of conversations and panel discussions, which are hosted live on the website. And we're going to be adding lots more videos as well. So we're encouraging everyone to go on the website, check them out.
And is this something that will develop over the next few days and weeks? It's not just confined to this week of MWC?
Yeah, absolutely. So at the moment, the team are busy filming some more as well. So it's updating every single day, and it will be for the next few weeks. So yeah, it'll be an evolving process.
Fantastic stuff. Great to see innovation there at the heart of the GSMA as well. Also, Zara, I should mention that you were very involved in the GLOMOs this year. It was a big year, wasn't it? It was a special year.
25 years. Yeah. So we've been celebrating the GLOMOs for 25 years. So that didn't, the cancellation of the event didn't stop us at all. We still went live on Tuesday. I'm obviously a little bit biased, but I think if there's one thing that people take away from this week, it's looking at the list of the winners. It really sets the compass for the industry. Who are the leaders? Who should you be talking to? And which tech is really coming into the foreground as well? So again, that winners list is on the website, and everyone should have a look at that.
Great stuff. We've covered a lot of ground in the last few minutes. Peter, if I can, just as we come to close the program, is there anything else that we haven't discussed in this conversation that you think would have made headlines at MWC this year?
Yeah, I think a couple of things that we were looking for, and you saw some of this reflected in, I think, the GLOMOs, as Sarah was saying, just the continuing push onto enterprise and verticals, right? Where that's going forward, how vendors, how operators, how the whole ecosystem is targeting that, right? I think that's a big push that would have expected to have seen. You still see it, right? Those launches, right, don't go away, right? You see the network slicing launches from all the different vendors, you see the use cases. But the other piece, which I think has been a discussion point for this last year, will continue to be this next year, supply chain, things like open networking, open RAN, right? It's not surprising if you look at the GLOMOs, again, a bunch of the big winners were around things like open RAN. Why? Really important. Again, that's not going away, right? You saw the announcement with TIP. Again, we'll see more of it this rest of the year.
Peter, Zara, Kavit, thank you very much for joining us. We are out of time, but it was great to wrap up a very different MWC 20 Barcelona, but we'll definitely be back next year in Barcelona. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll see you next year. Thank you.